What projects in KwaZulu-Natal is Royal Hospital in DHV South Africa currently involved in?
In KZN, we are involved in three sectors, that is actually the business lines. The first one being water. Typically, we are looking at the reservoir and also the Richmond pump station. That particular project is actually addressing water provision to the areas that actually have inadequate supply. And also in water, we are involved in waste water treatment. That is actually the water you drink, then it goes there, you retreat and you drink it again. So that is actually the technologies that we actually provide. And one of the technologies being the Nereida plant that we have actually launched in South Africa. The other area that we are actually involved is in transport. Typically, when you look at the P577, which is actually a project of KZN Department of Transport. That is actually linking communities. So there are actually areas that have been neglected. And with the urban sprawl, you start actually getting congestion. So it's actually those solutions that we actually provide to the KZN Department of Transport. We have close to about 400 technical people in KZN. So there are a lot of projects that I'm not going to touch on. There are areas around industry and buildings. And in that area, we are focusing on provision of energy, that is transmission and distribution. We are also working together with the tech queen, that is on waste to energy, that is actually salvaging what is really remaining out of waste to convert it to energy. So those are actually the areas.
How will Royal Hospital and DHV expand further in KwaZulu-Natal?
We have been in KwaZulu-Natal for 95 years. And to tell the truth, we'll be there for the next 100 years. And the areas that we are actually focusing on in terms of our challenges, the first one being the water challenge. With drought that we have seen, there will always be, like in KZN, the need for further expansion of the water infrastructure. And the other areas of the challenge would be the urban challenge. On the urban challenge itself, when the urban sprawl, the city is actually growing bigger than what we are. So there will be the need for further infrastructure in the urban. And that links to energy provision. To actually say that, we need energy in your towns. The other area that we looked at was actually an industrial challenge, the growth of industries around the KZN area. That's the area around the aerotropolis. That in itself actually demand other forms of energy. Because as we have seen with the blackouts we had in the country, the load shedding. So that means that we should actually be providing renewables, geothermal, waste to energy that we have already started, gas to power, and LNG in those areas. So those are actually missing infancy currently. We are expecting those areas to actually grow drastically. The other area is actually the transport challenge. With urban sprawl and also trying to shorten the distance between towns, so there'll be high-speed trains in the case of an area, linking the north and the south and linking to the Gauteng region in the coming 20 to 50 years, and also the demand for BRTs and light rail in the towns. So our work is cut out for many years to come.